Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. It is so lovely to have you back here on the channel, and I do hope you are enjoying the content I am making. So in this video, I'll show you a very quick way using DaVinci Resolve 17, one of the new features, how to make this old silent film effect with the flickering and some things you might want to think about if you want to achieve this effect. If you are new to this channel and want to learn DaVinci Resolve filmmaking tips and tricks and having a look at some pretty cool gear, I would recommend you to subscribe. Okay, let's get right to the video and let's start to make old silent style videos. Let's go. Okay, so let's get right to this little bit of a tutorial and let's make this old silent film style clip out of this one. So there is a couple of things we need to do to make this clip work for us. So let's start by going to the clip, right-clicking, and then let's go into the clip attributes. And one thing there is with old film or back when they did the silent films, they were usually not shooting at 24 frames a second. They were actually shooting at around 12. So we are going to change this to 12 frames in the inspector, and I'm just going to push OK. And as you see from the playback, this is now a little bit more chubby, which is quite nice. What we also saw in the old movies were that there sometimes were not jump cuts, but just because of the way that it was filmed, things didn't move right in the frame. So for instance, let's see, we have a car here. So we'll have the car here, and I'm just going to do a cut, and then I'll just go a couple of frames forward. I'm just going to zoom in as well. I'm just going to cut that portion out. So now we have these abrupt things going on in the frame. We also have a car here. Let's say we'll do a cut here as well. A couple of frames. Again, I'm using the arrow keys for this thing here. Okay, so now we have a couple of places where it looks a little bit strange, like so, and that's totally fine. So next thing we are going to do some color grading. Either we could put in a adjustment layer, or we could and this is what I'm going to do. I'm just going to right click on my three clips because I do have cuts in, and I'm just going to do a new compound clip. And I'm not going to care too much about the name. So now we have a new compound clip with the clips inside, of course. So let's go to the color page. And first off, we are going to make this picture here black and white. And we're going to do this the easiest way possible. And that's simply just by taking the saturation and dragging that down to zero, going up to the contrast, and either we could add in some contrast, like something like there, and then I'll go to the lift, and I'm going to crush the blacks quite a bit. So you can see if we click up here, we have done this to our image, black and white, with the hard contrasty black shadows. That's basically what we have done. And that is more or less all we're going to do right now. So let's go. Actually, we could do this from inside the color tab and using the effects, but I intend to like to do it from the cut page or from the edit page instead. So let's go up to the effects library, and we're going to just search for the flicker, and this is the new flicker function in DaVinci Resolve 17, and we're going to add that into our clip, and we're going to go to our inspector and to the effects, and here we actually can change things around. So per default, this is actually what we have, but we want to make it a little bit more extreme. We can change the flicker from left to left. So it does something like that. And I think that is what we are going for. But we also could, of course, use the gain to flicker, or we could go for the Flickr vignette thing here. And actually, maybe we're just going to keep the Flickr vignette. Okay, and then we could, of course, change the range of that. We could make it super extreme to the point it's making no sense. We're just going to give it a little bit of Flickr. Maybe we'll give it a little bit more, something like that. And then we could change the speed, and we're not going to make it as rapid. Let's say something like this here. And then we also have some smoothness. We could smooth out the thing a little bit. And also we can then go down here in the Flickr quality. And we could randomize the scale here. We could scale it up or scale it down. I think we should do something like this. Let's go back here. And then we could make some pauses. How the Flickr are. I think actually we could make that a little longer. Something like that. Yeah. And then we could also pause individuals, and it's on 5, but we can actually make that on 3 instead. And I think that is kind of fun. And then we also have the random seats here, and we can bump that up to 4, I think. So it is totally random what it does every time. Actually think the pause length should be down a bit. Something like that. And also we could, again, readjust the speed of this thing. Something like that. Okay. So with that on the way, again, we could add a little bit more. And I tend to love to add film grain. So I'm just going to write film grain here. Going to drag that on. I know this is a studio feature, so you don't really have to do this, but I tend to like to do so. So let's go into our film grain here. And what I tend to do is I want to see grain only, and I'm going to make this to custom, and then I'm just going to customize my grain size. So I'm going to make it extreme, going to make the size bigger. Again, messing around with the texture and the grain's aspect ratio. We could do something like that. And the strength of the grain, we could make it a little like that. And again, we're also going to make it a little softer and a little saturated, something like this. So you can now see, if we look at this thing, if we take off the grain, you can actually see what it does. And actually, I think I want to go a little more extreme. So I'm going to make the texture like here and the grain size bigger. Something like that, I think. A little more extreme like that. Okay, so that's what we could do. But there's still a thing we could do to make this even better. And for that thing, we'll actually need to go to back to the color tab, and we're going into this tab here where we can either blur out our image or we could make it sharper. As you see, if we drag down, we're going to make it sharper. And I don't want to make it sharper. I actually want to make it softer. Not too much, just a little bit. So we can actually see from what we did. This was the original clip, and this is what we have done to it now. So it's a bit softer. Last thing to do. As you all remember, if you've seen silent movies, the aspect ratio were kind of different back then. So if you want to do this in a super quick way, you could just go up to the timeline and go down to output blanking and put in 1.33. So we're having this black lines here. And that would be the super fast way of doing it. There's a little bit of a bonus thing here. And again, if you want to try out this bonus thing, I did. I'm just going to reset my output blanking here. So again, this is not necessary to do at all, because you could just use the output blanking. There's one way of more way of doing things as there is in DaVinci Resolve. We could also use the cropping options and then crop the left and right as we wanted. And then, for instance, put in some softness to make these soft corners like that. That's also a way of doing it. The last option is, of course, to use assets. And I have some assets here from Rocket Rooster. Some overlays you can check out down in the description for the Rocket Rooster things there, down in the bottom of the description. They are affiliation links, so if you buy anything from there, you're going to help out the channel, but it's not necessary at all. But then I have these rounded PNG files here. I'm going to put those on top. So we have now this old aspect ratio. Again, we could also add in some, some scratches. And let's see, some extreme scratches. We'll put those on top here. Actually, we are going to put them here. And then we are just going to go into the inspector. And we're going to go down to the composite mode. We are going to add in screen. And then we are just going to drag out the opacity quite a bit. And then, of course, we could just control Alt and drag to make a copy. And then we have kind of done that. So when you have added all of your layers, you could easily drop in some music. My music is from Soundstripe. Again, I use this service for all of my things. So if you're interested in music, stock video and sound effects, check out the link down in the description below and use the affiliation link if that is something for you. So put in the music and you're going to have something like this. That is one way of doing a silent film effect inside of DaVinci Resolve 17 using the new Flickr function and using overlays from Rocket Rooster, even though that is not necessary at all. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it will help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.